So good morning dear friends. So we are going to learn about human resource management, introduction of human resource management in this class. In the previous class we have learnt about the syllabus of human resource management for BBA third semester second year students. Today we will learn about the definitions of human resources management given by eminent personalities or eminent persons, concept of human resource management and functions of human resource management. What are the functions of human resource management also we will come to know in today's class. So but before that we will understand the process of human resource management. In order to understand what human resource management is, you have to know what are the functions that human resource management does, that performs. Human resource management performs what types of functions? If you know the activities that are there in human resource management, you can understand the concept of human resource management in a better way. So you can see human resource management is the process of recruiting, selecting, inducting employees, providing orientation, imparting training and development, appraising the performance of employees, deciding compensation and providing benefits to the employees, motivating employees, maintaining proper relations with employees and their trade unions, ensuring employees' safety, welfare and healthy measures. So all these are included in human resource management. Now let us start with recruiting. See, recruiting, in our previous class I have mentioned there are two ways of recruitment: internal recruitment, external recruitment. Internal recruitment refers to promotion, demotion, transfer. Promotion means a lower cadre candidate will be upgraded to a higher order. Means, let us take for example, a junior level clerk is there. You make him senior level clerk. An ordinary teacher is there. You take him to the rank of headmaster. So that is promotion. Demotion means opposite of that. From a higher level, you change that person to a lower level. You bring that person to a lower level. That is the demotion. Means, let us take for example, a senior level officer. He has made a mistake. He has made committed a crime. So you change his designation to a lower level clerk. From a senior level officer, he has been given demotion as a lower level clerk. So promotion is going to be there, demotion is going to be there, transfer is going to be there. You can apply transfer also. Means we have several branches, several offices are there for you. From one branch to another branch, you can transfer a person. So that is internal recruitment. External recruitment means you can conduct walk-in interviews, you can advertise in the press, you can advertise in the websites, and you can recruit persons from outside world, those who are not working in your organization. With the help of various means, you can employ them, you can recruit them. That refers to recruiting. And selecting means, suppose 5 posts are there, 50 persons appeared for interview or for written test. So you will conduct test and based on that you will select appropriate persons. Only 5 are required. Out of 50 you will select 5, but and the remaining 45 you will show them their home. So that is selecting. The inducting employees, so all this induction is a process by which newly recruited employees will be given training, will be shown what to perform in the organization, how to perform in the organization, when to perform in the organization and where to perform in the organization. That is the process of induction and providing orientation. See, orientation means the newly recruited employees will be given orders as to where to sit, how to sit, what are the guidelines, what are the rules and regulations, what are the rules for promotion, what are the rules for demotion, how a person can be transferred, how salaries are going to be paid, what are the benefits that are associated with a post in the organization. All this refers to orientation. So employees will be given orientation and imparting training and development. Newly recruited employees will be given training and developmental issues will be made known to employees. So all these are concerned with human resource management. I am repeating, human resource management refers to managing employees in the organization. Getting best out of employees in the organization is important to achieve goals of the organization. So human resource management is concerned with only employees, their recruitment, their promotion, their salaries, their transfer. So then, and human resource management is concerned with appraising the performance of employees. What is appraising? Appraising means they will be made aware of their merits. They will be made aware of their limitations, how they are working in comparison with their previous performance, how they are working in comparison with others' performance, how they are working. That is appraising the performance. And deciding compensation means how much to pay. Suppose an employee is injured in the organization while in work, he has to be paid certain amount. See, recently you must have heard about fire accident in Srisharam power project. 9 employees died on the spot in Srisharam power project. So in that case, the concerned department, the GENCO, has to pay compensation to the families of the employees. Means compensation means something in return for the sacrifice made by the employee. So compensation needs to be decided, and you have to provide various benefits to the employees. Means the benefits means maybe in some organization you can see if employee's job nature is such that he has to travel daily, traveling allowance will be paid to him. For traveling how much distance, based on distance, based on mode of journey, some amount will be paid. That is providing benefits. In some organizations you can see employees are being given quarters. Means let us take for example, Singareni employees are there. They will be provided with quarters. They will be provided with the free electricity facility. They will be provided with every month one gas cylinder will be provided to them. So these are providing benefits to the employees who are working in the organization, and medical benefits will be provided. Okay, so all these are included in human resource management. Then motivating employees. What is motivation? Motivation implies, motivation means offering something to the employee. When he achieves the goal prescribed by the employer, means let us take for example, a small child will be offered a chocolate if he narrates a story in English or in his mother tongue. So that is motivate, that chocolate will act as a motivator to the small child to narrate a story in his mother tongue or in English. So motivation refers to something which is offered as a benefit to the other person to act positively towards a thing. And human resource management is concerned with maintaining proper relations with employees and the trade unions. You can see in every organization we have trade unions nowadays. Employees form together as a union. If at all any problems are faced by employees, unions will fight on behalf of the employees. So human resource management involves maintaining proper relations with employees and their trade unions. And human resource management is also concerned with employees' safety. Means various safety measures that are to be taken at workplace. Maybe providing you see the case of Singareni employees. Those who work in the underground, they will be provided with helmets. For that helmet itself, you will have light so that underground, if they go, when they go, the lighting will be sufficient for them. So even if anything falls on their head, the helmet will protect them. So that is ensuring employees' safety. And welfare and healthy measures. So in order to provide certain welfare measures like canteen facility or providing a restroom facility to the employees or providing what you call as a car parking or vehicle parking sheds to the employees for the benefit of employees. So these are all concerned with human resource management. These are all facets of human resource management. So as the name itself implies, human resource management, the subject is concerned with human resources, right from their recruitment and selection to their retirement or to the termination of employees. Human resource management takes care of all these activities. Now coming to now you can see the human resource management is concerned with procurement, development, maintenance of human resource. Means this is just like their recruitment, their selection, their providing training to them. So all these things are concerned with human resource management. So human resource management, if see, employees are the biggest assets of any organization. Even though an organization may have crores of rupees, crores of worth equipment is there, but if it does not have proper human resources, all of them are going to be a waste. All of them are going to be a burden for the organization. So human resource management, proper maintenance of human resource management results in achieving individual, organizational and social objectives. So human resource management is a multidisciplinary subject. Multidisciplinary subject, multi means many. So it deals with, human resource management deals with many subjects like management, psychology, communication, economics and sociology. So human resource management is mainly concerned with these subjects. So that is why it is a multidisciplinary subject. Multi means many. Disciplines means the pieces of knowledge. So many subjects are included in or related with human resource management. So management means in simple terms, management refers to directing others to perform their activities. To manage the affairs in simple terms. So managing means to see to it that others perform the work given by the organization. So psychology, as you all know, it is the study of mind. It is a study of soul. What a person is thinking. You know about psychologists. A psychologist observes the minds of others. Okay? So human resource management is concerned with psychology. Human resource management is concerned with communication. What is communication? communication refers to transmitting our ideas to others. So in communication, always we have two parties. One is sender of communication and the other one is receiver of communication. So now in our class, now you can see I am the sender of communication. You are the receiver of communication. So I am sending message to you. You are receiving message. And the medium is there. That medium is internet. That medium is my laptop. That medium is your cell phone. That medium is Zoom. Okay. So human resource management is concerned with management, is concerned with psychology, is concerned with communication, is concerned with economics. See, in your first semester, you have studied business economics. Economics is a subject which deals with optimum utilization of scarce resources. The resources are scarce. In nature, all of you know, scarcity means availability is less, demand is more. We want more of the resources, but availability of resources is very limited. So the subject of economics teaches us how to utilize the scarce resources in an optimum way, in a best way. So human resources are very, very limited. And we have to make use of those resources in an optimum way. So in that way, the subject of economics, how we are applying, you please understand. In our earlier time, we have learned that those persons who are recruited in our organization need to be paid salaries, need to be paid compensation. So how much has to be paid? Economics will help us. Human resources are scarce. Very less talented people are available. We have to make them payment. It may be salary, it may be compensation, it may be anything. So economics teaches us how much to pay, when to pay, where to pay, why to pay. All these are concerned with economics. So that is why, in order to satisfy human resources, we have to take the help of economics. Now coming to sociology. Sociology is a subject of society. Means how you all know Aristotle, the great person Aristotle, mentioned that man is a social animal. In my previous class, I must have told you in our earlier classes, in previous semester, man is always going to work in groups, going to live in groups. If a man lives in isolation, means singly, if a man is living, that person can be of two kinds. One, he must be a mad person, or he must have been a god. Only then he can live in isolation. He can live singly. Otherwise, we are all social animals. We have to live in society. We have to live with the society. So in society, organization is going to work, and from the society itself, employees will come. So in order to understand the nature of the employees, we have to study the society at large. What are the customs? What are the traditions? What are the principles, rules and regulations that are being adopted by the society? We have to learn first. So this human resource management subject deals with all these subjects: management, psychology, communication, economics, and sociology. Okay. Now, human resource management deals with team spirit and teamwork. As I have already mentioned, just now I mentioned, we work in groups, we work in teams. So what is team spirit? What is teamwork? We have to learn, and human resource management helps us in building team spirit, in working in teams, how to work, it will teach us. So it is comprehensive. Human resource management is comprehensive. Comprehensive means it includes everything. Nothing is left out. Means in relation to an employee, everything will be discussed in human resource management. Nothing is left out. So all matters relating to employees will be discussed in human resource management.
So comprehensive means includes everything. Nothing is left out. All are included. Nothing is left out. So human resource management is a continuous process. See, every year you have to train the people. Every year some persons may be retiring in your office, in your organization. You have to send them out, and the new persons you have to recruit. So human resource management is a never ending process. It is a lifelong process, continuous process. As long as an organization continues, human resource management will exist. You have to continue. Okay, so now we will, so these are the tasks associated with human resource management. Now just you must have understood by this time what is human, what is resource, what is management. Now quickly we will come to know about these concepts. So human resource management is a combination of these three words: human, resource, management. So human, we are all human beings, you know it. So but with reference to human resource management, human implies skilled workforce in an organization. See, in my example I mentioned, we have 5 posts in our organization. 50% applied. So we have to select only 5, and the remaining 45 will be shown their home, will be shown the door to them. We have to show the door to them. So human, so those 5% who are selected are the skilled, remaining are not fit for you for the time being at least. So human resource management, in the subject of human resource management, the word human does not simply mean that only an animal which has 2 hands, 2 legs, 2 eyes, 2 ears, nose, lips. This is not human in human resource management. It refers to the skilled workforce in an organization. Okay, then resource. See, when the topic of economics came just now, I told what is scarce. So resource is that thing whose availability is limited or scarce. In our subject, we learn that human beings are very precious or very important in an organization, whereas skilled human resources are very scarce. So that is why it is the workforce of humans is referred as resource. Means very scarce resources are available for us. Scarcity is there. Dearth is there. Okay. Now management. Management refers to optimization. Optimization means getting maximum from minimum. Okay. Make best use of limited resources or scarce resources. So human resources are limited. Let us take for example in our country 130 crore population is there. But how many can work as teachers? How many can work as engineers? How many can work as doctors? How many can work as priests? How many can work as drivers? How many can work as conductors? How many can work as police personnel? How many can work as electricians? How many can work as plumbers? How many can work as teachers? That knowledge is very limited. Only a few persons can act as, can act such activities, can perform such activities. So managing them means getting optimum, means getting maximum from such scarce resources refers to management. So human resource management is concerned with the skilled workforce, is concerned with the scarce resources, scarcity. Human scarce resources of human beings are there, so the scarcity will be taken care of by the subject of human resource management. And managing these scarce resources, getting maximum from this scarce resources of human beings, you will learn in human resource management. Okay, now coming to the, in the introductory remarks I mentioned, we will come across the definitions given by famous personalities, famous persons in human resource management. So Edwin Flippo has defined human resource management as planning, organizing, directing, controlling of procurement, development, compensation, integration. Integration means joining two activities, two groups activities, maintenance and separation of human resources to the end that individual, organizational and social objectives are achieved. So as I already mentioned, it refers to planning, organizing, means grouping them. In the organization, you will do various activities to various personnel. So you will organize the activities of the organization. So directing them means when to perform a task, where to perform, to whom a person should report, why, when, where, how, what, all these things will be dealt with by human resource management. Development, compensation, integration, maintenance, and separation of human resources. To see to it that individual goals are achieved, at the same time, organizational goals are achieved, and at the same time, social objectives are achieved. That is the role of human resource management according to Edwin Flippo. So coming to the definition given by the National Institute of Personnel Management. Okay. Human resource management refers to that part of management which is concerned with people at work. Please note this, people at work. It is not concerned with any other resources. It does not concern with land. It does not concern with capital. It does not concern with entrepreneurship. It is related to purely men at work and with their relationship within an enterprise. Its aim is to bring together and develop into an effective organization of the men and women who make up enterprise and having regard for the well-being of the individuals and of working groups to enable them to make their best contribution to its success. So it deals with human resource management. Is that part of management which is concerned with the people who are working and their interrelationship among the workers in the organization, in the enterprise. So its main aim is to bring together all the individuals so that effective organization is developed. What is effective organization? Effective organization implies objectives of the organization are achieved with minimum effort, with minimum money, with minimum time. Maximum output is received by the organization. That is effectiveness. So effective organization is there in the place by taking care of people at work. Okay, so it takes care of individuals, not only individuals, independently, individually also it takes care. And when they work in groups, then also human resource management takes care. So for the all this, for the success of the organization. Okay, so that this definition is given by National Institute of Personnel Management, India, NIPM. Now coming to definition given by DeSanto and Robbins. Human resource management is concerned with the people dimension in management. Since every organization is made up of people, acquiring their services, developing their skills, motivating them to higher levels of performance, and ensuring that they continue to maintain their commitment to the organization. So commitment of our employees is essential to achieve organizational objectives. So what is commitment? Commitment implies employees 100% giving what he is capable of. Suppose I can teach in a better way to you,
More than this, I can teach. If I am committed, I will go to that level. If I am not committed, I will not go to that level. I simply think that majority of you are absent. Why shall I teach? Why shall I teach that much? If I am not committed, then if I go to the highest level of my teaching capacity, that is commitment. So, human resource management is the subject deals with bringing the best in the employees. So this is true. Regardless of the type of organization, government, business, education, health or social act, this definition is given by DeSandro and Robbins. So today we have learned about all these things. I hope you understood. Now you can interact with me. So thank you very much, dear friends.